Okay, so this is a Stirling motor. This is a basic, very simple, basic motor where you have two chambers where the air heats up in here, pushes this in, then the air passes through here, and then this sucks it. And these are 90 degrees out of phase. Therefore, the actual flow is the mechanics of how he built it is allows the flow to create the perpetual motion, or it's not perpetual, it's just basically it's a influenced motion. In other words, the air pushes this cylinder that's inside here back. Then as the air passes through here, and then it cools from these heat sinks, and even cools more with these heat sinks. So this side's creating a suction, this side is creating a pressure, positive pressure, which pushes. Then even as it passes, it creates a suction, which allows it to go, you know, basically push, pull, push, pull, push, pull, push, pull. And the actual motion of it going sort of influences each other. This one influences that one, and that one influences that one. But it's all started by this heat that's created here, which is just a small flame. The interesting thing about the Stirling motor to me is the simplicity of it. There's really not that many parts to this. When you really look at what it does, you can probably even build it with fewer parts. This is sort of a more fancy model. It could be engineered even. It could be balanced and get even better response out of this motor. So it is very simple. It's something that they used really a lot back in the old days with the wood burning motors and all that. But it's sort of like more about going back to old technologies than this is nothing new. You know, this is just a little more fancy because you have the little glass bulbs. Anyway, I wanted to show you how it worked. And basically all it is you light your little alcohol. This is just alcohol. You know, I recommend that you use the regular isopropyl rubbing alcohol. The cheap stuff has, I think, 30% water. The good stuff has about 9% water, and then some people will burn, like, you know, vodka or PGA just to get the pure, but it's hard to see the flame. And then you can even burn other types of alcohol as long as you know what you're doing and what it is. So basically what's happening now is that there's the air that's between those two cylinders here is heating up. So if you give it a little push, you'll notice that it spins a lot longer than it did. Well, it's already taken off. Usually it takes a few seconds longer than that. But basically now you have air that's heating, being pushed into here, and pushed through here, and sucked out here. And because these are 90 degrees out of phase, it creates sort of an influenced rotation, an influenced continual. Those of you that would like to attempt to build it, it's very simple. There's nothing highly technical about it. As you can see back in there, it's just a simple cylinder. This may be a little more complicated, but on the actual measurements, but basically it's simple, nothing fancy. As you can see, it's flying pretty good there with just that little bit of flame. That's it. That's actually quite a bit of flame. I usually don't put that much on it, but you can hear it. Now, as far as what it takes to stop it, it doesn't take a lot. But, you know, you can see it almost wants to take off on its own. But that's the thing about Stirling, is you do have to give it a little push. And it picks up on its own. This is where I want to be. Here with me, so close to me. It's a mild pressure. Okay, and then you notice after you blow out the flame, which you can see there's no flame. It still takes it a while to stop running from the heat that's built up in there. It's still running off the heat, basically. So it's just transferring, you know, some shoots out here. Some puffs out right there. And that's the Stirling motor. That's the very basic principles of the Stirling motor. You can check out Chevy, Ford, AMC, what used to be AMC, and they all built cars that actually had these motors in it back in the day. You know, if the 70s is back in the day, that's when they built them. Pretty interesting motor. They weren't that efficient then, but I'd say nowadays they would be extremely efficient, especially in hot areas like here in Vegas. So there it is.